Alright, everybody. Dude, preseason game 4 here. And unfortunately, some reason the cloud didn't save my preseason game 3, but had to re-simulate it, and they won anyway, so who cares? But anyways, let's finish off the rest of boring preseason. So let's get our weekly training out of the way. Alrighty. So, zone blitz. Okay. Do our levels again. Alright. Well, screen pass. Okay. Cover two. Cover two man. Okay. Let's see here. Akeem Ayers again. Yeah, let's work on him. 27. Eddie Royal. Let's actually work on Marcus Whedon. Younger. And has the same overall. Alright. Anthony. Yeah. We'll do that. Alright. Here we go. Sim and Sim. Alright. See here. See how much XP we get. Alright. Get all that XP. I didn't get to skip theirs. Oh, wow. Alright, we'll cut these guys when our final preseason game's out of the way. Alright. Here we go. Jeez, I'm an 89 overall? Really? Oh, my God. Dang. They're saying this is like one of my best teams I've made in Madden. I think most of my teams are typically 84 or 83. That's okay. Nice. Oh man, we gotta get Shady back up there too. A 90 overall. Alright, can I mute it? This is the NFL on EA Sports. There we go. This is one of the best non-divisional rivalries in the... Alright, let's go.
Thanks. We are across the Hudson from Midtown Manhattan at MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford, New Jersey. Tonight, the preseason draws to a close with a good matchup between the New England Patriots and the New York Giants. Here's Jarvis
Landry now on the return. Dang it. Oh, man. He's a good kickoff returner. All right. Here we go. I'll just do coach suggestions to make it quicker. Oh, wow. It actually tells you the game plan play. Nice.
They come out here in the eye. Now a former Tar Heel, Giovanni Bernard. Push his way forward to about the 32. It's a 6-yard.
He got a pretty good run, darn it. First play of the drive. Let's see. It looks like they are going to pass.
He was the finisher. A really nice run.
And they updated it to where I won't know if they're running it or not now. Darn them.
A second down throw for Bridgewater.
Oh, way out. What's Bridgewater doing in here? He got a freaking, what was it, ACL injury? All right, let's see. Go for the blitz.
Early three and out here on third and four.
An extra corner on the field for New England here on third down.
Yeah, another DB. Bridgewater from the gun.
Oh, God dang it. Ah, Jarvis Landry's cooking me. Darn it. Get out of here, man. Oh, I got a completed drive goal. Man, they just got a touchdown on me. That's bullcrap.
So on third and medium, they dial up the pass, and it works to hit the end zone.
Darn it.
It's really not a surprise to me. That's a throwing down in the NFL because of how tough it is to run the football. But what offenses like to do is still show run formations to make them respect it and throw out of those. In this case, they took a
nice
hit the end zone and made it pay off.
And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the
20. All right, let's see here. Establish the run first.
Here's the first carry for LeSean McCoy.
Nice.
Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs.
I'm often struck when I watch LeSean McCoy play. How often you just watch him and you almost get mesmerized by his style. And then boom, there's another 20-plus yard run. It's amazing how he pulls it off.
Ugh, nice.
Pick out of Pittsburgh, still doing it in the league at a very, very high level.
That's another nice run, and I have to tell you, some of the coaches that I played for, their philosophies were always different when they see a guy running the ball well. Some of them wanted to immediately go to play action and throw it now because it's wide open.
Ah!
Until they stop him, that big boy's going to keep getting the football, and that might be the direction that they're going to go right now.
See if they stay on the ground for second down.
Oh, go, go, go! Go! Yeah!
Fun for a guy trying to tackle it.
And he's brought down.
Nice!
13 yards and it moves the sticks.
How many times do we say in this game?
Now, keep going.
So many different ways. In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty. Can make moves, make people miss.
Oh, come on!
Before it can close down.
All right, Ron.
That speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary, and that led to a really nice game.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. Again, it's
come on. Almost.
Here for a good little gain. Give him four on the carry, and it'll make this a third and about two.
Now let's try to push it over LeSean McCoy.
Is in sync right there. Obviously, guy carrying the ball. But how about the people up front? There's leverage, athleticism.
I think he made it, didn't he?
He needed two, he got one, and that's going to leave.
Really?
And partner, when you run the ball,
we're going for it.
You're telling the whole world you've got nothing but confidence in your offensive line and your
running. Oh boy.
They were stuffed on that play. Only got 1 yard.
Come on. No. Man.
LeSean McCoy.
Come on.
The Giants are going
to. Dang it.
Not the way that they were hoping that possession would end, failing to convert on fourth.
And now they've got to make sure that they keep their poise, they keep their confidence. Just because it didn't work once doesn't mean if they get that same situation.
Oh, come on.
But they shouldn't go for it again. The defense feels great, but the offense, they can't be despondent. One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
Neutral zone infraction, defense.
Oh, my goodness. Come on.
And just a simple, basic neutral zone infraction here, partner.
Yeah, when you're ready to launch and go get the quarterback, sometimes you take off a bit too fast.
The gun, and he'll fight his way forward to about the 48-yard line. Call it a gain of a couple there, as it'll leave him with a second and just three. So second down, 3 yards to go now.
They'll play. All right, receivers left. Better get good coverage here. God dang it!
Tacked up front as penalty marker. So the hard count gets them there. Neutral zone infraction.
Yeah, the defense thought they had the timing down, but the quarterback hit them with a hard count, got them to jump.
Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. It's the Giants with a football here as we begin quarter number two, and they've got it here with a first down. the carry.
Oh my God, are you kidding me? Oh wow.
Concentration level may not have been there. I agree with you on that one, because those types of plays, when they result like that,
I'm getting stomped.
Lightning, aren't they? Whoosh, and off he goes. On the return, here's Marcus Murphy. And it's a pretty good return here, as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. And the Patriots gearing up to go now. And on the last drive, they were in field goal range. They just opted not to kick it, didn't get it. How does that change the mentality this go around?
I don't think it changes much for the head coach, because this
dang it
preaches all the time. Attack at all times in any spot on the field. And he likes touchdowns, not field goals. Now, your field goal kicker, you got to make sure you nurse him through and say, okay, don't worry about it. When we need you, you've got to be ready to go. And the team, of course, loves to see points on the board. So let's see if it changes a little bit in the same spot.
There we go.
See what the decision is here if they get to that spot. They give him 17 yards that time, as that'll move the chains.
Quarterbacks love slant routes because the receivers are breaking right into their line of vision. And receivers love them as well because they're getting the ball on the move and able to catch it and try and get upfield and gain additional.
Oh, go, go, go. Yeah.
Middle, it's Williams.
Darn it.
Similar to a slant, it's all about timing when you're throwing a crossing route. Quarterback and receiver have to be in sync, and when they put it on them just right and catch it full speed, running through a deep.
Pushing.
Down right at the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
When you put together a formula for winning defense, it's exactly what we're seeing in this game. Controlling the line of scrimmage, attacking, and changing everything so that now they're playing in the offense's backfield.
Ugh, almost.
And he couldn't quite get there. Tackled down at the one. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it, now the confidence is starting to rise.
Ugh!
Because that has happened,
man, Giants defense is freaking tough when up close.
You do say, guess what? We can throw it. We can throw it well with a whole lot of confidence.
Nice.
Patriot touchdown. Larry Donnell from a yard out. And the Patriots are back within a score. Sometimes those tight ends are a mismatch. They found the mismatch there.
And that's exactly why you want to draw up those types of plays, because coverage is just going to go to the natural guys, the guys that make the big plays on the outside. But if you work your tight end into it, that's a tough one for a defense to handle.
Tough. They couldn't handle it. It worked out for six. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The New York set to take the field. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
It takes me back to when we sat with the offense coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them,
stop
and make
them
it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. And there's a flag on the play.
Nice.
And down goes Sanchez.
Holding offense.
There we go. Second and 20. Third it. Of course, I'm going to decline it. I don't know why I had to wait on the computers.
Watch right, watch right. The Patriots going with a dime package here. Two extra defensive backs on third. Third and long, it's Sanchez.
Dang it.
To the sideline, and that is a heck of a catch.
There we go. Stopped him good.
Back now. as I search for my cue card here. There we go. Coming up at halftime, Larry Ridley will join us from Orlando. He'll have highlights and analysis from our first half of play.
Well read.
Yeah, thank you. Murphy now to return.
Ah.
A good return there. Call it 13 yards. And the Patriots take over. The Patriots' offense now. They work their way back onto the field.
All right.
Last time they were out, they scored. Still trailing here, though, so some work to do.
But it's okay in terms of mindset. Because they scored.
Darn it, you guys. Get out of here. Ugh.
Being down on the scoreboard because now their confidence is a little bit higher. They feel like they've got something going, and they feel like they can attack again and put more points on the board.
Are you scoreboard watching if you're the offense, or are you just focused on this drive?
Ha! Is that a face mask?
Everyone does it to some extent, but you've got to set it aside right now and just focus on this series.
It was.
The scoreboard if they punch it into the end zone.
Face mask penalty, and Charles, you were a defender. You know sometimes in the heat of the moment, it's hard to keep your hands away from that face mask.
Sometimes you just get out of position as a defender when you're trying to make the tackle, so you end up flailing away.
Whoa, I was passing to freaking A, not B.
Almost picked, but instead they'll keep it on second down.
Pretty nice coverage there, but a missed opportunity for an interception. Let's face it, a lot of these defenders, they've got it all. Speed, athleticism, hands, a little bit questionable.
Here's Clemens. And this is incomplete.
What the frick was that? Come on, man.
There's a good opportunity. Just went awry there. A drop pass. I guess that's why they call them running backs and not catching backs.
On third down, they dropped a throw.
Oh, he drops it. God dang, guys.
Fourth down. The Patriots will bring on the field goal unit. From the left hash, this from 39.
Today's NFL, these big guys are featured receivers. They move them all over the place to try and find...
You guys can't catch. Backups, darn you.
Off the drive with three.
And that should be the goal for an offense. Finish each drive with points. So that's a nice job there to come away with at least something.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Now out comes... And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play. I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it, or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it. No one got it. On second and 10, Sanchez. Checks it underneath to Langford. And he'll get it up near the 35.
Got injured.
34 here.
Jeremy Langford. Okay.
Sanchez wants to throw it.
Oh! Nice! Leon Hall with a nice interception.
And that's a great example of ball skills right there, partner. You and I do a lot of games, and I can't tell you how many guys look to run with the football before they've intercepted it. So that's a nice job of focusing on the task at hand and coming away with the interception.
They'll come out throwing here.
Oh, nice.
Quick hitter on the slant, that's complete. It'll go as a gain of 12. And that's good for New England, first down. And the offense moving quickly to the line. On first down, he'll drop to throw.
God dang it, frickin' Clemens.
Lost it there, and it'll be second down.
They did almost everything right. Excellent coverage, breaks on the football, just unable to haul it in and take it the other way. So he dropped an interception. It's a key for him now. Don't dwell on it. Just move on to the next play.
Ah!
Loose.
Dang it.
Looked like they had an opportunity for a big play across the middle, but he didn't have the concentration or the focus necessary and dropped it before he could haul it in.
Back to throw again.
Oh my goodness.
Played after almost being intercepted. A pick there would have been great. The good news for the defense now, it's fourth down.
Tremendous coverage there. Just did not catch the football and complete the interception. But what do they say all the time? If he had really good hands, he'd be playing offense.
So a field goal here. They're still down, but they put a dent into that lead before the break.
And that's got to feel good because now they've seen that they can put some more points on the board, and that gives them a whole second half to get back to where they want to be, and that's in the lead.
Here's the Giant offense now making their way back out onto the field. And with time quickly fading here in the
season, should be running it here.
Aggressively, offensively, they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains.
And that's how you run the football and run it successfully. Big time chunk of yardage picked up, but why? Offensive lineman won at the point of attack. They're leveraged way better than the defenders.
All right.
When you're getting underneath,
should be actually winning.
That's exactly what happened on that play. The offensive line moved the defensive front, created space, and the end result, a fantastic run.
Thanks, Brandon, and welcome to the EA Halftime Report. Let's take a look back at the first half. Giants have an edge in time of possession right now. The Patriots, though, are still right in this game and will certainly be looking for a way to pull this one out in the second half. So let's take a look at the highlights from the first half. Giants now late in the first quarter, and he'll eventually be brought down, but not before getting to the 47-yard line. Now midway through the second, pass coverage will break down here, and he finds his mark for the score. Patriots down by a touchdown.
It's a good interception by Leon Hall there.
All right, thank you, Larry. Plenty of intrigue to come. A one-point game as we get set for half two.
All right, here we go.
This is fielded at the goal line. To the 26-yard line.
Okay, I guess we'll get back to our running, I guess.
They'll run, it's Rodgers.
Oh, yes! Oh, no. Darn it, I thought I was freaking gone there.
Very solid gain of 27.
Every team in the league always wants explosive plays, breakout plays, and even more so when it's your horse who's had a tough time during the game.
Yeah, not that great in the first half. Maybe he can recalibrate here in the third.
Ah, man.
I like that. Recalibrate. Strong.
Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine.
You know, today's NFL really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their
time. All right, here we go.
Add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball.
Another good run. Yeah.
There's still a few inches to go, though, as it'll be third down at about the length of the football. Third down now following the run.
Oh, not a very good play to run here.
They'll need to get the playoff quickly. On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air.
Oh, yes. Whew.
That one good for 16, and the drive will continue.
It fits the exact right word. Over the middle, there's almost always traffic, so anytime you're a receiver in that area, you're not just focused on catching the football. You're wondering where the collision's going to come from, right?
Ah.
There's always someone there. Able to concentrate, catch it, and even added a little extra in the end with a short run. That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held them to a gain of two. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and eight. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
Now Clemens.
Wide open, baby.
Touchdown, Patriots. Larry Donnell with two touchdowns on the season, both in this game. And the Pats able to cash in for six.
I know we often laugh, and sometimes we even exalt the guys who are great trash talkers and give us some really funny lines. But the bottom line is absolute production on the field. His second touchdown of the game.
Oh, man. Darn it.
To preserve that lead. Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. Fielded about a yard deep. Oh, look at the juke. And he's up past the 20 to the 20.
Is that a face mask or a holding? Oh, okay. Nice.
Carry now. And an alley to run. And he'll be taken down at the 18.
Good thing my safety was there.
Tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
You run on a first down run, pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
To throw on second down is Sanchez.
Oh, yes.
As tight ends go, he might not provide the super flashy plays very often, but he's pretty reliable. Usually an excellent target, and normally catches what's thrown to him, but he didn't on that play. Third and five, so they bring in an extra defensive back.
Expecting pass.
Darn it.
And he's brought down after a good game. A good pick up there of 20 yards.
We can talk all we want about football being a game of strength and brawn. It's also a game of mismatches, and they're trying to create one there. Getting it to their back out of the backfield to make a bigger play.
As we often say, get it to him in space, let him use his leg.
Yeah, if he can get a matchup against a linebacker or maybe a defensive end dropping out in a zone blitz, he's going to win that battle just about every time.
A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
There's so many things that go into playing the position of linebacker. Some of them are actually subtle. Doing the drill work that you do all the time in practice and carrying it over to the game. Get rid of blockers and get to the ball carrier, knocking down for a loss.
Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard
line. Now, see if we can keep him from getting 2 yards.
Bring up a third down. Still in search of the first down after that last completion.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there, freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free down.
Come on! Yes!
A 1 yard gain on the play, and that'll mean a call to the punt team as it's fourth down.
Third and two, and they ran the ball for only 1 yard, and everybody's gonna scream at the offense. But let's give a lot of credit to the defense on that play. Defensive front out leveraged the offensive line. They got more people to the football.
Welcome back now here in East Rutherford. It's the Giants with possession of the football but needing points.
Alright, come on, guys. Looks like they're gonna run to the right. Ah, god dang it. Got it.
And they're able to pick up the conversion here on fourth down.
Oh man, fourth down and one, and you're on your own side of midfield. That takes a little bit of courage to pull off, but they went ahead and snapped it, and it'll work out for them as they get the first down.
Here's Sanchez. He's gonna flip one out here to his running back. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. 5 yards on the pickup, and it'll make it second down.
Now that's the type of play that gives you a chance to win. Nothing forced downfield where you don't have a guy open. Swing it out to the back on maybe even check it down, whatever you want to call it. Gain of 5. You're just trying to get 4 on first down. They're ahead of the chains now.
He'll find his man on the comeback route.
God dang it.
It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs.
As if he didn't have enough to think about on that route, the comeback route, coming back to the football and catching it, decided to make sure he toe-tapped and kept himself in bounds.
And that was spectacular, but on the comeback route, maybe a little easier to deal with the sideline since you've got better vision of it.
I think that's a great point because you should know exactly where you're going. And
oh, I was going to take Sanchez's face off there.
But yeah, coming back to the football, I like it. Good vision.
Just play after play after play on this long drive for the offense.
Let's go now. 20. Right 20.
Sanchez from the red zone now. McKinner here is complete.
Darn it.
Three of one tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else. It'll be a gain of six, and that'll bring up second down.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there were more people there to get him down.
And he'll fight his way down right around the 12. And he got half of what he needed there, 2 yards. And it'll bring up a third and two more.
Well, I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone. But these short ones still have their value. You can still set up your play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't.
Oh, no, he lost the football.
Get up. God dang it. You freaking morons. Couldn't get that.
Well, that was a big oops right there. But how about his ability to correct it? Loses the football. Able to get it back himself.
Yeah, pounced right back on it, keeps possession. And Novak's kick is good. And that will cut the lead down to just two. All right, so this one's now back within a field goal. And if anybody tells you they see how this one's going to end, I'd have to say they're probably lying, Charles.
And this game's had more twists and turns than a good mystery.
Oh, screw you. Screw you and your giant freaking bias.
Time is starting to run out.
All right.
We'll see if the defense can get the stop they need to get the ball back to the offense. Now Rodgers.
Oh, go. Yeah, baby.
13 yards there on the pickup. And it'll be first down, New England.
Whenever we meet with coaches and they always talk about wanting to establish running the football, it's oftentimes with a good tight end who can control the line of scrimmage and the point of attack, and they're becoming harder to find because the colleges are giving us a whole lot of receiving tight ends.
Aha, you jerks.
Who can run, not necessarily block very well. In this case, though, we saw two tight ends on the field, both of them with ability to block, and he ran the ball successfully behind that power.
Ah, almost. God dang it.
Denell, the one he was trying to get it to. And that'll make it second and 10.
Normally he's pretty reliable, usually catches what's thrown to him. On that play, he simply dropped it.
On the ground, Rodgers.
Ugh!
And he's across the 40, 3 extra yards to the 43. A nice job to get 8 there after the incompletion, and now they'll look at a 3rd and 2 coming up. Offense coming up.
All right.
2 yards on 3rd down. They come out here in the eye. There's Clemens.
Aw, man.
The H-back, Ryan Hewitt, the intended receiver. And it'll be 4th down.
Darn it.
Brad Wing now, as he's on to punt for the first time tonight. This is away and a very good kick, angled for the sidelines. And this will be out of bounds at the what here? The 12-yard line.
Come on, guys. We got to stop him.
Ready. Black 35.
He's back to throw. Looking left sideline, incomplete.
All right.
Hawkins, the intended receiver. And it'll be 2nd and 10.
No.
They're going to hurry back to the line now. He'll look to throw.
No.
That's complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
Come on, one. Oh my God.
And that leads to a New York first down. And they got exactly what they wanted there. Out route, catch, get out of bounds, stop the clock.
And I have to criticize defense here because you know the situation. You want to keep them in bounds and have the clock run. So I'm sitting on the outside portion of the field. and not letting him throw an out route. Throw anything inside, and I'll make the tackle. An out route? That's not the way you're supposed to play it.
And now they're in the hurry up. They'll look to throw. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end.
Darn it!
Down, but not before they're inside the 25. They pick up 12 on the play there.
Come on.
Sanchez now to throw. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. The sack recorded. It's a loss of 5, and now it's second down.
Hopefully the field goal kicker stinks.
Black 35.
Now it's Sanchez.
Oh my God.
19 yards on the pick.
Wow.
First and goal. That's what they need right now. Get the first down. Get out of bounds. Stop the clock.
Just playing smart football. Understanding the situation.
We need an interception.
It's necessary and making sure that clock stops at every opportunity.
First and goal here from the 9.
Come on, push him in. Push him in.
Now we're going to get a timeout here called by the Patriots. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages.
Hey, 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 hey. Four down.
Second and goal from the 2-yard line. They'll try to run it with Carey. And he gets halfway there down to the 1-yard line. Calling a gain of a yard as they get a little bit closer here. It's third and goal.
Now they're going to give me a little bit of time.
It's just a preseason game, but this is for the win. And the 10-year vet knocks it.
Dang it.
And it's celebration time.
Freaking Giants, man. I can't believe this.
In the final seconds. And Charles, he hasn't missed a kick all year. Why would he start now?
Exactly. And this was by far the most nerve-wracking. They just stepped up and...
Well, got one play. I don't even know if Clemens even has the arm for this.
All right, here we go.
One final shot. They'll look to throw.
Oh, my God. Are you serious? Wow, man, are you freaking kidding me? Aww. Yeah, it just has to be the Giants. You freaking gotta be kidding me. Aw, man. Darn it. Well, that sucks. I'm gonna be cutting a lot of defensive players here. That defense sucked. Alright, so while I do my cuts, I'm gonna mute this. Mute, you... Oh my god, are you... Mute. There, thank you. I cannot believe they beat me. Yi. What the heck? Man. I cannot believe that. Wow. All right. They recommend the, okay, these guys, are they who they recommend? All right. I'll cut him. He's 29. Move him. Cut him. All right, cut him. All right. So, all right, now we can finally start the good stuff. Set season goal. Okay. What's that? 7 wins, 8 wins. Nah, we're going to go all the way. Make it to the frickin' Super Bowl. Alright. Okay, guys. Well, that's it for preseason.